Charging. 4, 3, time.
Thank you.
Week in review. Here are this week's major stories. A series of successful operations against the League of Reparation has led to much of the terrorist group being dismantled. But while the group has been dealt a severe blow, agents have yet to identify the organization's coordinator, Nexus. Meanwhile, an independent report suggests that a French Thargoid worshipping cult may in fact be harboring undercover Thargoid agents. A leading ex-theologian responded by saying that he did not believe the group to be a threat, despite its unsettling beliefs. Political journalist Katia Carvalho has compiled the profile of Jordan, sister and fiancé of Princess Ashley Duval, for the Imperial Herald. The article documents Rochester's family history and raises the question of how he will balance being both a federal statesman and an imperial consort. In other news, celebrated author Olav Redcourt has begun a promotional tour that will take him to over 50 destinations throughout the Core system. The tour will support Redcourt's new novel, Corsair King and the Storm of Desire, the 14th in a series of swashbuckling historical romances set in the 27th century. Didier Mancha, Empire's Grace, has completed work on the Tiberian Academy, a flight school for Imperial Naval Cadets, and is hosting an inaugural banquet to mark the event. The organization has placed an open order for exotic food and drinks to be served at the celebratory banquet, and issued an appeal for mine resources, which will be used to construct a statue of Admiral Meyer at Imperium. Finally, the campaign to supply a scientific project in Colonia has now concluded, and construction of a resource management center has begun. Hundreds of independent pilots made the journey to deliver commodities to Tier Technology Services in the Tier system. And those are the main stories this week. A profile of Jordan Rochester. Responding to public interest in Princess Ashley Duval's fiancé, Federal Ambassador Jordan Rochester, political journalist Cassia Carvalho has compiled the profile for the Empire. Jordan Rochester is now a household name throughout the Empire, though few were aware of him prior to his engagement to Princess Duval. But in the Federation, the Rochesters have been associated with success for over 200 years. The Rochester name can be traced back to self-made tycoon Otto Rochester, who was the biggest landowner of Big's colony in the Altair system. Each generation since has strived for fame and wealth, and the expression as rich as a Rochester has become common parlance. The target destroyed. Darlene Matriarch is Isolde Rochester. She is a member of Congress, an influential figure in the Liberal Party and a staunch supporter of Shadow President Felicia Winters. Isolde raised 5 children, including Jordan, and it was her accomplishments that inspired her son to enter politics. Jordan's siblings chose different paths. The eldest, Jupiter Rochester, is an executive with Cordan Ethics, with a personal fortune in the billions. 15 years ago he had his own celebrity marriage to actor Thomas Turi. They now have 2 teenage children, daughter Carly and son Kaelin. Jordan's sisters, Juno and Jocasta, have impressive Navy careers, holding the ranks of Vice Admiral and Post Captain respectively. Only Jordan's younger brother, Jonah, has no title. He is believed to be the black sheep of the family. Despite being just 34, Jordan has already made his mark. He has overseen several high-level negotiations on behalf of the Federal Diplomatic Corps, and is now a trusted envoy, noted for his charm and tact. His future will be interesting, to say the least. How will he balance being both a federal statesman and an imperial consort? And what are the wider ramifications of the Rochester dynasty aligning with the House of Duval? Even more so than his predecessors, Jordan Rochester has already ensured that history will remember his family's name.
Friendship charge detected.
Diomantia Emperor's Grace Academy inauguration. The Didiomantia Emperor's Grace has completed work on the Tiverion Academy, a flight school for Imperial Naval Cadets. The organization is hosting an inaugural banquet to mark the event, and to honor the late Admiral Myra Tiverion, the organization's founding member, who will have a monument erected at the site. A spokesperson for the Didiomantia Emperor's Grace released the following statement. The Tiverion Academy will provide new recruits with cutting-edge training facilities to host a fitting banquet for its inauguration. We require help in sourcing a range of exotic food and drink. We also require a quantity of gold to make the monument raised in the Admiral's memory a truly spectacular tribute. The campaign begins.
to supply a scientific project in Colonia has now concluded, and construction of a resource management center has begun. Hundreds of independent pilots made the journey to deliver commodities to TIA Technology Services in the TIA system. Professor Alexei de la Vega, in charge of the research project, made this statement. TIA system. Starport status update. This report presents the latest data on starports experiencing technical issues as a result of Thargoid sensor-related interference. The following starports are currently closed. Arendt Dock, HIP 17838. Gerry Gateway, Tshika. Gentle Survey, Jolagra. Gordon City, Ayangori. Meanwhile, the following starports are on the brink of closure. Hurston Platform, Yamahan. Malphus Terminal, Pleiades Sector, HR, W, D1, 41. Newman Camp, Shinrata Desra. Mitchell Ring, Carnewag. Delay Survey, Ahamaker. Cube Mugdal Enterprise, Kakas. Norgay Hub, Obambori. A Thargoid fifth column. Amid growing public mistrust of a fringe sect that worships the Thargoids, a report suggests that the group's members may be undercover Thargoid agents. Independent journalist Flint Firemaker Lafos shared his theories via the Rewired news feed. I'm sure you're all just as creeped out as I am by those hooded monks and their stinking hive chapels. Granted, being creepy isn't a crime, and I'm as live and let live as the next man. But isn't it strange that this cult is rising just as the Thargoids return in force? The idea of humans working on behalf of aliens might sound crazy, but think about it. All those escape pods captured by Thargoid ships, what did they want them for? After a bit of brainwashing, they'd make perfect spies, sent back to infiltrate humanity using this religion as a cover. What scares me is that these freaks don't communicate. They just lurk in the dark, waiting. Why are they so mysterious? What's going on in those chapels? For all we know, they're seeding our planets with barnacles and eggs, right under our noses. Leading exotheologian Dr. Alfred Ulyanov responded with this comment, I can categorically answer one point. The reason the Thargoid worshippers are not interested in communicating is that, from their point of view, we will all be dead soon. As for the rest of this speculation, nothing in my studies has caused me to suspect this group to be a threat, despite its unsettling beliefs. Major victories against the League.
on docking bay 2-1.
Thank you.